All right, Soul Family, we're going to talk about how a lot of European white folks have a lot of animal DNA in their genes. For example, you notice those melanated people in United Kingdom, Canada, and USA who try to act hard and want to act like wannabe thugs and shit. A lot of these wannabe thug acting melanated people, they be so quick to want to fight another melanated person, but when it comes to them white people, man, they don't want to fight them. White people got animal DNA. White people literally got their bone structure is like the Achilles heels of a canine. Because, European white people be doing cross country and shit like an actual canine, having a lot of stamina. White people got a lot of stamina to fight for a long periods of time, like a lion, like any type of animal that you see in wildlife. So, like, when these wannabe thug ass melanated people come across these white people, man, they be so bitch made afraid. They don't want to fight these white people because white people, they fight to the finish. They literally fight to the finish like a hyena, a lion, a wolf. We know wolves fight for a long time. We know lions fight for a long time. An alligator fights for a long time. A lot of white people got animal DNA. Like, for real. Like, when you find out that type of information, it could scare a person. It'll scare these damn wannabe thug ass, NBA young boy ass type people, man. I'm telling you, these are all facts. I guarantee you, man, the same people who had the audacity to jump me or try to sneak attack me and shit because I'm another melanated person, man, they would never did that shit if I was white. Because then, you know what happens when you jump white people or try to attack white people from behind? They're gonna get their get back until They gonna get that get back until somebody's dead for real, man. That's how, cause white people crazy as fuck. Like, for real. They got animal DNA. That's why a lot of wannabe thug ass, hard acting ass, melanated people don't try to ever jump white people or sneak attack white people, cause they know white people crazy as fuck when white people get violent. Cause white people be violent as fuck. They got animal DNA like an alligator, a lion, a canine, like, for real. Melanated people, their DNA comes from the sun, the cosmos, and shit. That's why melanated people are naturally chill, right? Melanated people who act like wannabe thugs and shit, they feel like they get cool points for attacking a melanated person who is chill as fuck. Because me, I'm chill as fuck, man. I actually act like a real melanated person. I don't act like none of these damn European white folks. I don't act like no wannabe thug. I don't got no animal DNA. My DNA is from the sun. My DNA is from the moon. But I guarantee, if I was fucking white, I would never know what the experience, what getting jumped feels like, getting attacked from behind feels like, or ever knowing what a fight looks like or feels like, because I'll be a white person protected by white supremacy, man. White people. Like, for example, let me give you an example. The Rocky movie, Rocky Balboa, he is nicknamed the Italian Stallion. This guy could take a beating. He got animal DNA. This guy got DNA of a horse. He fought Ivan Drago, right? Ivan Drago's a fucking machine. Ivan Drago got the animal DNA of a fucking elephant. Like, come on, man. Like, when you know these things, man, it's like, it make you watch and move. Like, come on, bro. Come on, man. We know how crazy white people get when they do get violent, bro. Like, especially in fights. Like, white people, like, they don't stop until somebody's, like, erased, man. Like, they crazy for real, bro. They super crazy. Like, when it comes to melanated people, man, it don't even get that wild. White people just take it to a whole nother extreme. That's why when you go to poverty neighborhoods and you see a lot of wannabe thug melanated people, especially them light-skinned ones, talking about, like, they Piru or they Great Street Crips or whatever. When they see these white people, oh, now they cowards now. Now they want to be on their best behavior because they'd be like, oh, shit, it's a white person. Oh, shit, it's a white man coming through. He got that animal DNA, man. They white people crazy. These wannabe thug melanated people get silent. They get quiet when these white people come around. But as soon as they get around other melanated people, that's when they feel all brave and shit, man. I'm telling you, these are all facts. You think I'm lying? Go see it for yourself, man. When's the last time have you saw a melanated person get in the midst fighting another white person? When's the last time you seen it? And don't say no pay-per-view fight with Floyd Mayweather versus Ricky Hatton, because that don't count. Those are boxers. We're talking about people in the streets. When's the last time have you seen it? You haven't. Especially in the south of USA. Like, if you ask any melanated person, if you ask any wannabe thug-ass melanated person, when's the last time they, got in the midst with somebody, they're going to say it's another melanated person. They're not going to say it's he was white. Why? Because a lot of wannabe thug melanated people, they know white people get crazy when they fight, man. A lot of wannabe thug-ass melanated people, when they see these white people, man, they just walk the other way. They walk the other way. They be like, nah, I don't want no problems with this white person, man. They crazy as hell when they fight. Because they know the deal. The white people got animal DNA. That's why a lot of white people, Europeans, they always go to the zoo to see their ancestors. Like, for real. They got animal DNA for real. That's why they carry dogs everywhere, man. That's no joke. This stuff ain't nothing to laugh about, for real. Like, I just don't see, man, these wannabe thug-ass melanated people, man. I tell you, they'll have the quick, they'll try to jump me or try to attack me from behind with the quickness when I'm not even looking or don't got no animosity, right? But when it comes to the white person, these wannabe thug-ass melanated people, they can see a white person in front of them, a white person not even noticing that they're there, and these wannabe thug-ass melanated people, especially them light-skinned ones, they don't want to attack that white person from behind because they know the white person is protected by white supremacy, and they know the white person going to go crazy on their ass because white people got animal DNA, like an alligator, a fucking python, snake, a fucking saber-toothed tiger, all these ancient, strong-ass animals. White people got gorilla DNA. A lot of white people got chimpanzee gorilla DNA. They strong as fuck. They crazy as fuck when they fight. Like, come on, bro. Why you think a lot of white people tend to be offensive linemen and defensive linemen, bro? Why you think the strongest man and strongest woman in the world, per se, had to be Europeans? Because they got animal DNA. You know, a gorilla is strong as fuck. It would make sense to be the strongest weightlifting person in the world. You got to have some animal DNA inside you. Like, come on, man. So when it comes to fighting, man, a lot of wannabe thug-ass melanated people don't want to square up with no white person, man. Come on, man. If I was a white person, ain't nobody would never in their life ever dare put their hands on me. They know they would never do that shit. They would never do it. But they feel comfortable doing so with dark-skinned people. A lot of people just feel so comfortable to put their hands on dark-skinned people because dark-skinned people have not put no fear in these other folks for fucking with them. Like, for real, history has shown this. History has shown this, man. A lot of my ops, for example, they lucky that I never chose to get the get back with them. They lucky that I never chose to get the get back with them. Because if I wanted to get the get back so bad, man, I'll find so many ways to get a pay-per-view fight and try to force my ops to challenge me in the ring. But me, I'm look, man, it's whatever. I know my ops can get it anytime. Sign the papers, they're getting their ass whooped on TV. I get paid a bit money for embarrassing their ass. And my ops, they'll get paid some money even after they get their ass washed in the ring. But that's a whole nother story, man. As far as this topic about white people having animal DNA, it's all true, man. They always walking dogs and stuff, having different type of animals, iguanas, snakes, pet alligators and stuff. What does that tell you? You know what they say about those European white people that got alligators, snake pets, canines in their houses, bro? You don't want to fight these damn people, man. They're crazy as fuck. They got animal DNA. Like, you don't want to, come on, man. You don't want to fuck with them, man. Like, they're going to fight, man. They're going to fight to the last breath. A lot of these white people are so crazy, man. When they get violent, they'll fight somebody over a damn, they'll fight somebody over a chicken sandwich, bro. Like, for real. You think I'm lying? Try to fuck with a white person today and go see what I'm talking about. It's going to get violent. You try to fuck with a dark-skinned person, they'll probably just brush it off and act like nothing happened. Because dark-skinned, melanated men, for example, they have no choice but to brush it off and try to act like nothing happened. And because dark-skinned, melanated men can't do nothing about what happens to them, they got to stay silent. And it's a fucked-up-ass thing. I talked about it in my last topic, man. But, man, we going to go, bro, I'm telling you, man. I'm telling you. These white people, man, they get crazy when they fight, man. And these wannabe thug-ass melanated people who think they get cool points and brownie points for fighting dark, for jumping and sneak attacking dark-skinned people, man. Try that shit with a white person and see if you still exist. When it comes to my ops, man, all of my ops that had attacked me and shit, all of my ops that had the audacity to sneak attack me or jump me and shit, if I was a white person, man, a lot of my ops would not be living right now. They'd probably be dead somewhere. They'd probably be dead somewhere if I was a white person with animal DNA, man. But since I'm a melanated person, I don't got animal DNA, so I'm more chill compared to these wild Europeans. Like, for real, bro. A lot of my ops better be lucky. They better feel lucky. They better be glad that I came out a melanated dark-skinned person that got DNA of the cosmos. But let's not get it twisted, though. Like, dark-skinned melanated males, when they do have animosity, man, we could be just as dangerous as them white folks. We dark-skinned males could be just as dangerous than white folks. If we really chose to get busy and shit, man. If we really chose to get busy, bro, like, man, a lot of the ops wouldn't even believe their own eyes, man. A lot of my ops wouldn't believe their own eyes if they ever saw me really get busy for real. Nobody in their life ever saw me get busy for real. Never. And I think that's where they kind of fucked up at. Cause by nature, I'm a fucking laid back ass person. Like, for real. Like, I don't try to, like, prove my gangster to nobody and shit, man. I don't be trying to do all that, man. Like, that's just not my style. That's not my steez at all, man. So, when it comes to these wannabe thug ass melanated people, man, if you want to see how dark skinned males really get busy when we get mad, Just hit me up for a pay-per-view fight. It could be for $800, $900, $1,000, $10,000, $1 million, billion. Hell, we'll do this shit for fucking $50. We'll do this shit for $50. That's how bad I want to fuck up my ops on pay-per-view TV. Because a lot of people think they could just fuck with dark-skinned melanated males and they think we ain't going to do shit about it. Because the system doesn't protect dark-skinned males at all. But guess what, man? When it's pay-per-view fight time, it's a whole different story, man. You know, I want my ops to feel my rage in the ring. On TV, with money on the line. A lot of these wannabe thug-ass ops of mine, man, they gonna be like, damn, I didn't know he would like that for real. I didn't know he could get like that. I'm like, yeah, like, I got the animosity. What's up now? We on TV. Like, don't change up now because everybody watching now. Because everybody be so quick to do things when nobody's looking. But when the TV's on, when the camera's on, oh, now these wannabe thug-ass melanated people want to be bitch made afraid on pay-per-view TV. Yeah, you jumped this person behind the scenes, but now everybody's watching on TV. Now you don't want to fight them. A lot of my ops don't want to fight me on TV. They know not to do that shit. A lot of my ops duck me when I have animosity. They do that shit. They feel the most comfortable when I'm chilling. But when I got animosity, a lot of my ops, they know not to fuck with me when I got animosity. They know this. I might not be a wild ass white person with animal DNA, but shit, I could fuck some shit up just as much as a violent ass white person when it comes to my ops who hate me because I'm fucking dark skinned, right? But guess what, man? All of my ops, man, you want a pay-per-view fight TV, man? Set it up, man. Set it up, man. It don't matter how many months. You could train for fucking 20 months. You could train for 20 years for all I care. You're still going to get washed. Because I'll be training as well once the fight gets scheduled. All of my ops, man. You specifically know how dangerous these white people get. That's why you don't ever try to attack them. You try to attack dark-skinned males like me because you know dark-skinned males are not protected by a white supremacy system. That's a cowardly move, if I say so. That's a cowardly move. Like, for real. A lot of my ops, man, you're gonna get yours one day. You're going to get yours one day. And it's going to be on TV. With money on the line, with billions of people watching me wash your ass in the ring, and you get embarrassed. Like, for real, man. Like, all I gotta do is fucking kick to the knees, kick to the private part, and it's done. It's fucking done. Like, for real, man. All of my ops who jump me and fucking sneak attack me, man, you don't want to get in the ring with me. You don't want to do that with a bunch of billions of people watching on TV and money on the line. Then you're going to freeze up because, oh, you can't do whatever you want to do when the camera's off. Now all that wannabe thug ass nature is gone out the window when billions of people are watching. That's why I can respect people like KSI, Logan Paul, Jake Paul for having celebrity fights. At least they're not scared. At least they not bitch made afraid to handle people in the ring face to face when they actually looking. Who the fuck attacks people from behind or jumps people when they not looking? That's coward as fuck. Like, for real, man. A lot of my ops know that I got boxing gloves, right? Now, granted, they never really see me have animosity and actually unleash that motherfucker and actually fucking break bricks with that shit. They never seen that shit, bro. They never seen me break bricks by kicking or none of that shit. They saw that shit, they probably don't want to fuck with me no more. They probably would never do that shit, man. Like, for real. All of my ops, man, they gonna get fucking destroyed in the ring if they ever sign papers to do pay-per-view fight with money on the line. And I know this topic was about talking about white people with animal DNA that gets violent, but man, like, just knowing how fucked up my ops had, like, fucked my head up when they jumped me or sneaked attacked me, like, for real, man, like, I really got to talk about that shit again on part two. During this topic on this podcast, I really had to do it, man. Like, come on, man. Like, all of my ops, man, like, it's crazy because a lot of my ops that sneaked attacked me or jumped me before, man, when they saw me in person again, it's like they didn't have the same energy because they knew I had animosity the second time I saw them. And so it's like, oh, he might got animosity this time, so I ain't gonna try nothing. I'm like, yeah, you damn right. Like, you want to try this shit on pay-per-view TV? You want to try to fight in the ring? What you want to do? What do you want to do? Because you are going to be food. For real. Like, all of my ops don't want it with me on pay-per-view TV, man. Like, come on, bro. They don't want that shit, man. I'll end up, man, bro. If I ever had animosity towards anyone in my life, it would be my ops. And I don't be sitting there being angry at people and shit. But when it comes to those who fucking sneak to tap me or jump me and shit, man, and I finally process what fucking happened to me, I'm like, okay, yeah, I got some animosity now. We got to fight in the ring with pay-per-view, with money on the line, with billions of people watching. Because they damn sure didn't want to do that shit with white people around because they know white people get violent and crazy due to white people's animal DNA. But hey, man, I'm telling you, dark-skinned males, we can get just as crazy too. We might not be as crazy as them white people trying to fight to the finish until somebody dead, but hey, we dark-skinned males get crazy too. Go ask a lot of my Jamaican brothers. Go ask a lot of my Ghanaian brothers. A lot of my fucking dark-skinned Asian brothers. A lot of my dark-skinned island brothers. They'll confirm this shit. Like, come on, man. This shit is so lame, bro. Like, these wannabe thug ass melanated people who think they hard and shit because, you know, they jump a dark skinned person or they sneak attack a dark skinned person and think they, oh shit, I got cool points now. I just fucking sneak attack a fucking dark skinned person. I jumped a dark skinned person. Whoop de doo. You're a coward for that shit because dark skinned people are not protected by white supremacy. There's no such thing as dark-skinned, melanated supremacy. So what cool points did you get? And I'm talking to all you wannabe thug-ass, light-skinned, melanated people out here. You NBA young boy-looking-ass motherfuckers. You fucking webby-looking-ass motherfuckers. You goddamn fucking exhibit-ass motherfuckers. You goddamn 24K golden YK Osiris-looking-ass motherfuckers. I'm talking to you. Like, for real, man. Like, oh, and a lot of these light-skinned, melanated males in the South, they grimy as fuck, especially in Louisiana. They grimy as fuck. They shiesty as fuck. They think they hard and shit because they jump dark-skinned people. But they don't want to fucking do that shit with a white person now, would they? Because they know a white person going to get crazy on their ass. Like, for real, white people got animal DNA. Like a damn snake, like an alligator, a canine, a fucking elephant, a fucking wolf, a jaguar, a fucking horseman. The list goes on. A lot of these wannabe thug-ass, light-skinned, melanated people know white people crazy, man. Why you think a lot of these wannabe thug-ass, melanated people who beat up on dark-skinned people, they get bitch made afraid when a white person come around? Especially when a white person look like a fucking bodybuilder, having fucking 8-packs and fucking broad shoulders and shit, man. Come on, bro. Like, come on, bro. Like, a lot of these wannabe thug-ass melanated people don't know what they be getting into, for real, man. I'm telling you. Like, bro, I'm telling you this, man. All of my ops, for real, man. All of my ops, man. If you wanna get in the mix with me, all you got to do is just sign the papers to pay-per-view and fight me on TV. It's not that hard. Like, trying to jump me and sneak attack me, that shit is bitch made afraid, man. Like, you not no real warrior to do that shit. Bro, anybody could jump somebody. I could go jump 20 people right now and not get noticed at all. I could go ambush 20 people right now and get away clean with the shit. When they not even aware. It's so easy to sneak attack people. It's so easy to jump people. Man, Bruce Lee got killed in his sleep. Bruce Lee got killed in his sleep by his ops. Because his ops be getting their ass whooped by him face to face. So they had to find a way to drug him because they was big mad against Bruce Lee in the movies. And the movie directors that was controlling Bruce Lee contract, they drugged and killed him like a coward, sneak attacking him. So many people attack me like a fucking coward. instead of directly saying, like, I don't like you because you're dark skinned. If you don't like me because I'm dark skinned, just say that. You don't gotta be all subliminal and try to jump me and attack me from behind. Like, just say you don't like dark skinned males. It's that simple. If I say I didn't fuck with light skinned melanated males, I would just say that. If I say I didn't fuck with Europeans, I would just say that. Instead of being all subliminal and try to jump people, attack people from behind, that's not a real martial artist, man. Like, for real. Like, come on, man. And you know what's crazy? I actually know a lot of shit. If I ever develop animosity to fight for survival, I actually know a lot of shit when it comes to self-defense. If I ever was in survival mode. And I don't think my ops would ever want to do that shit ever. I hope they don't do that. I hope they don't make that grave mistake to do that. Because they'll be foolish as fuck. All of my ops will be foolish as fuck to do that shit. They'll be foolish as fuck to try to come at me when I'm in survival mode with animosity. It's so easy to jump me and sneak attack me when I'm chilling. But if I got animosity and I'm ready to fucking Hakai somebody out of existence or fucking erase somebody out of existence, oh, it's a whole different me. Like, for real. Like, you know, when it comes to dark-skinned melanated males, when they're angry, it's a whole different type of anger compared to white people, even though it's not as violent. But it's not to be taken lightly, man. And I think that's where a lot of these wannabe thug-ass melanated ops of mine, that's why they try to, they try to, like, think it's shit is sweet with me and shit. Because I don't got animal DNA like these white people, so I don't get violent. But that don't mean that I can't fuck nobody up now. Come on now. But that's all I gotta say, y'all.